Once upon a time there was light in my life.
Now there's only love in the dark. Nothing I can say, a total eclipse of the heart. A total eclipse of the heart.
All right!
Hey.
Shut up my eyes.
Okay, again, let's give it up for Dave and Linda.
I have a great idea. Come to karaoke tonight.
Hey, if it's good enough for Koreans, it's good enough for me.
All right, let's go pick some songs so we don't have to wait forever to get up there.
And next up, we have Raul, our busboy, and Jimmy Rockwell.
Okay, forget it. Let's go. No.
What? We just got here. I thought you wanted to sing.
I did, but now he's up there.
So, who's he?
That's Jimmy Rockwell, the karaoke Nazi. Every year, from November 1st to New Year's Day, he takes up every slot available. And the worst part about it is, all he ever sings is Last Christmas by George Michael.
Oh, why does he do that?
He doesn't have a choice. He just gets everyone to sign up to sing Last Christmas, and then he stays up there and sings with them. Look, he's got the bus boy with him now.
Ooh-wah. Ooh-wah. Come on, bro. Ooh-wah.
Hey, stop!
One, what? What's up?
Hey guys, I know you got like a reputation for going around all the karaoke bars and, you know, taking all the slots and singing Last Christmas, but not tonight, bro.
Right. You just don't understand, my friend. You see, 8 years ago, on Christmas night, as my mother was laying on her deathbed, her family gathered round her. And as she was taking her last breath, George Michael's Last Christmas came on the radio. And for the next 4 minutes and 47 seconds, my mother sang. She sang with joy, not sadness. And as the song came to its end, my mother gently passed away with a smile on her face and that song in her heart. And I'd like to think that Last Christmas gave her, well, gave her her Last Christmas. And so now every year during the holidays, I sing Last Christmas for my mom.
Dude, that's a beautiful story. Go tell it to the sidewalk. Get out of here, buddy.
Yeah!
Free bird! Free bird!
Drop that swing!
Sing it.
It's TMI Hollywood. With music by Ben Provist.
Everybody, welcome to TMI Hollywood. Woo! We have a great show for you tonight.
Hey guys, sorry I'm late. Yeah.
Who are you?
I'm your week's guest, the Ukrainian whistleblower.
Oh, come on. You're not the whistleblower.
Oh, yeah, I am. That's why I'm wearing the bag over my head, so I can keep my identity safe.
Well, if you're the whistleblower, prove it.
Oh, my God! It is you.
Like I said, Yeah.
Say, man, with everything going on right now, like, what are you doing here?
Well, as you know, I've been getting a lot of buzz and heat these past few weeks, and I would love nothing more than to just go somewhere and not be seen. And I thought to myself, well, what better place to not be seen than my hosting the show?
Yeah, that's right, Jim.
Yeah, so what stories you got for me this week?
Well, Emma Watson's not upset about being turning 30 and not being in a serious relationship.
It's part of the new single positive movement.
You want to know something I'm positive about?
What?
That if she keeps saying things like being in a self-relationship, that she's going to remain single. McDonald's CEO Steve Easterbrook was forced to resign this past week because he had been involved in a relationship with a coworker. Apparently that's frowned upon at McDonald's.
But I guess fake meat is okay, right?
Yeah.
I don't understand. It was a consensual relationship.
Whether it was consensual or not is irrelevant, Steve. This is McDonald's. When someone here says me too, we have to supersize our response.
You know, when you write a stupid business conduct policy, you don't expect it to come back and bite you on the arse.
Steve, workplace relationships are a lot like our food here. When it goes down, it's pretty good, but eventually it just leads to heart disease or getting fired. Or both.
Yeah. Right, well, I guess I'll just put on my CEO big boy pants and step down. I'll have my assistant write my resignation letter.
Well, that's good, but...
But what?
But the boss is here and would like to have a conversation with you before you do anything.
He's here?
Yep, he's here. He's right outside. He just flew in, and I'm gonna tell you, he doesn't seem very happy.
You know, I'm just gonna quit right now. I'm not even gonna clean out my desk. You can give it to the next CEO. It's fine.
Unfortunately, Steve, he's out there right now. You can't just walk out.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Can you do anything for me? Put in a good word so you go easy, please.
It's too late.
Now, come on, man! Come on, get me out just this one time, for old time's sake!
Steve, pull yourself together! Listen, you never know how the pain's gonna feel until it happens. You basically go numb. You might even black out, but you wrap your belt around your arm like a tourniquet, you drive yourself to the closest emergency room.
Oh, God. Oh, Jesus, Mel.
Bon voyage, Steve.
How's it going, Big Mac?
Oh, it's going good. About 5 minutes, I'll be great.
Oh.
Please, sir, he already said he'd resign without any trouble.
Oh, that's all fine and dandy, but we all know what happens when you bring shame to the McDonald's name.
Big Mac attack?
You get Big Mac attacked! Now, somebody go get me some rubbing alcohol and a damp towel for afterwards.
Oh, my God!
I think I'm just gonna help her with the rubbing.
Where do you think you're going?
I mean, this... Mac, this is between you and Steve. I can help her with the...
I'm gonna need you to help me clean all this up after I'm done taking care of this thing. Steve Easterbrook! Boy, oh boy, what a disappointment you turned out to be. Hey, you know, was it worth it? Was this broad really worth what's about to happen to you?
It was really good.
Well, it was really good, he says. Was it so good, like curling of the toes at the very end as you're about to drift off into a coma-like sleep good, or just getting your rocks off good?
It was deep coma sleep good, Mac.
Oh, that's great. I'm really glad to hear that, Stevie boy, because you're gonna need a good memory to relieve some of the pain that's about to unfold upon you. Mel? Grab his arm.
Okay.
Oh, come back. No, come on, please. We can talk. It's true. Come on, we're both men of the people.
Both men of the people, huh? Because from where I'm standing, there's a man, and one of us is a clown. You know what the difference is between me and you, Easterbrook? Is that I know where and when it's appropriate to use my quarter pounder, and it's not appropriate to use it at the workplace!
I know.
No, you don't know! Do you know how many girls I could have partied up back in my day because of my fame, huh?
I don't know, man.
A lot! But that doesn't matter. I'm a businessman now. And the business can't be run in no burger joint when the only 100% beef patty that it cares about is the one in his pants! Ba-da-ba-ba! innocent, but he's your boss, so he's responsible.
As much as I wish I could say I was innocent, in all good conscience, I can't.
What are you trying to say?
What I'm trying to say is I pursued Steve. I couldn't resist that British accent, and I just went up to him and I said, does a burger and fries come with that shake?
She said that, she really did.
And then I said, I got a fillet of fish in my drawers and you got the pole to catch it.
She said that to you, huh?
Yes, I know, it's a terrible euphemism, but it was very erotic in the heat of the moment.
I said that so much worse, mostly involving items on the breakfast menu. But, you know, it's not his fault, it's just he can't resist my womanly charms.
So I did, I gave in, yeah.
If anyone should get Big Mac attacked, it should be me.
Food for thought, Mac.
All right. Set it. I can't do it. It's giving me indigestion. Besides, I can't Big Mac attack a lady.
She was no lady, Mac.
You shut up, you mutt. That being said, I'll accept Steve's resignation.
So you're not gonna Big Mac attack him?
No, not right now at the moment. Steve, you can go. Well, you too.
Okay.
So, Doc.
Yeah?
Why don't you tell old Mac a little bit more about this fillet of fish?
For all the stories you try to miss, I'm Cameron Weir, and this is the TMI Minute. Kanye West says that his endorsement of Donald Trump was God's practical joke to all liberals. Well, you know what they say about jokes. If you have to explain them, dot, dot, dot.
You know, sometimes you need some crazy mother to change something.
Kansas City citizens voted to remove Martin Luther King's name from a city street and return it to its previous name. Martin Luther King, ironically, is now living the dream of many people in that he no longer has to be stuck in Kansas City. In her new tell-all book, Whitney Houston's longtime friend Robin Crawford claimed that she and Whitney were involved in a secret lesbian relationship for several years. That was until Bobby Brown put a crack in it. You get it? Crack? Too soon?
They work for me.
Donald Trump is reportedly in talks with producer Mark Burnett to revive The Apprentice when he leaves office. Given Donald Trump's reticence to personally fire people, though, his catchphrase this time will be, "You're resigned." O.J. Simpson is suing the Cosmopolitan Hotel in Las Vegas for defamation after the hotel banned him in 2017 for being drunk and belligerent, which Simpson denies being. No word yet on whether O.J. will look for the real drunk and belligerent.
O.J., yeah, la, 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 la.
Oh, mamma mia, O.J.
O.J.
Yeah, she knows that. Oh, jeez.
O.J.
When a story breaks in Hollywood, we'll be there with the crazy.
Is this your entire party?
Oh, no, we're still waiting on a friend.
Okay, I'll be back when you're ready to order. Friday's supposed to be couples day night, Alice.
Who else did you invite?
I know it's supposed to be a couple's date night, but Sue's hitting the big 3-0 this weekend, and she doesn't have anyone special to celebrate it with, so I invited her.
Just what we need, another evening spoiled by fifth wheel Sue.
Oh, come on, guys, give her a break. Being single is tough. That's the only reason Rob and I are still together.
Sure, like Gina always says, dating is much worse than a marriage of disappointment. Now, look, I know you both mean well, but we don't need another evening dragged down by Sue. I mean, she just goes on and on about how miserable her dating life is, or how she's gonna die alone with all those cats.
Let's just hope tonight's different.
Oh. Sorry I'm late!
No, my landlord says 6 is the limit, so.
Well, whatever it is, Sue, you just are positively glowing.
Oh!
Well, wait a second. Did you meet someone, or?
Well, if you must know. Yes, I did! I met myself!
Yeah, sounds about right. Huh?
Well, a couple of weeks ago, I was home depressed because I will
die alone, surrounded by my cats. And then I saw an interview with Emma Watson, and she said instead of dating, she's self-partnering.
Oh, and I thought, well, H-E double hockey sticks. If it's good enough for Hermione, it's good enough for me.
So you're dating yourself?
Alice, I'm not dating myself. I'm self-partnering.
Yeah, you know, I tried that for about a month in college. You're gonna need more hand cream.
Oh, I can't wait. I just can't hold it in. It's time for me to introduce you to me. Come on out.
Hi, everyone. I'm Sue's other half.
I'd say better half.
I don't know. I think you're a pretty good half yourself.
Oh, you're just being kind.
That's what I love about ourselves.
Question.
So do we call you both Sue?
No. You can call me Other Sue. I just find it makes it less confusing.
Yes.
Sue, let me get this straight. So instead of actually going out and finding someone else, you literally split yourself in two.
Yes. So I've read enough self-help books to know that if you put your mind to it, you can do anything.
Now, of course, putting our mind to it didn't quite work out for us when it came to landing that dream job or losing that extra 10 pounds or finding the perfect mate. But the self-partnering thing was a snap.
I'm the best thing that ever happened to me. Jinx!
Do you really think this is the healthiest life decision? I mean, this sounds like something people in the Philippines would do.
Yeah, Sue, I think you just need to put yourself out there one more time.
I did.
And here I am.
What can I say? We complete me.
Self-partnering is, how do I be diplomatic about this? Confusing.
There's nothing confusing about self-partnering.
Oh, the waiter has an opinion. How do you know?
Sir, you might not be able to tell by looking at me, but I self-partnered.
You do?
Just ask your waitress.
I did not know we had a waitress.
Now you know, darling. Jinx!
Table 6 customers, this is Donna, she's my feminine side.
Isn't this so great? We've never been happier!
Jinx again! Wow, self-partnering must be very satisfying.
Oh, more than satisfying. When you're self-partnered, you no longer have to worry about
creepy blind dates.
Dates that ghost you.
Dates that are married.
They're dates that tell you they used to be a man.
Self-partnering is the best! Jinx!
Gina, what are you doing?
Shut up, Rob. I'm trying to self-partner so I can get out of our loveless husk of a relationship.
Not if I self-partner first.
Just ignore babbling of idiots.
Believe. Believe. Hi. I'm Other Rob.
Hello, I am Other Gina.
Hey!
What? What the hell?
Yeah, it doesn't work out for everybody.
Well, who wants drinks?
Me!
Jinx! Staff, you get out of here!
Yeah, I go.
So, guys, what other stories you got for me?
Well, social media went crazy this week when Keanu Reeves, who is like notoriously secretive about his personal life, was photographed holding hands with artist Alexandra Grant.
People went crazy after a photo of them holding hands.
Yes.
I wonder what fans would have done if they would have seen a photo of her holding John's wig.
Well, that's some nice wordplay, Jess.
It's rumored that Pete Davidson broke up with Once Upon a Time in Hollywood actress Margaret Qualley and is now dating Cindy Crawford's daughter, Kaya Gerber.
You know, I'm really struggling to temper my dickishness, but why does this keep happening?
I don't know. I really wish I could explain why Pete Davidson dates Cindy.
No. Another couple's getting up to leave. Why is this happening?
Anyways, this week, he's a tad upset, so don't leave. This week, Chris Brown took to Twitter to announce he's having a yard sale at his place in Tarzana, and he even tweeted the address.
Now, that doesn't sound like anything that could go completely wrong.
That man is violently ill.
Oh my gosh. I think this might be one of the belts that Chris Brown used to straighten Rihanna out with.
Honey, Chris Brown is so rich, he can afford so many belts, it's probably not one of the ones used to straighten Rihanna out with.
Well, actually, the little lady is correct. Rihanna has seen the downside of this here belt. Now, if you look closely, you'll see a certificate of authentication attached.
Oh, wow, it's real!
Oh my gosh, this is a collector's item, babe. We have to get it. Would you by any chance know how much Chris Brown wants for this?
Of course I know! My name is Carl. I'm the executor of this here yard sale. The price is gonna be $72.50.
Ooh, that's a little rich for my blood.
Yeah.
Speaking of blood.
Is that Rihanna's?
Well, it's a Chris Brown belt. It's gotta be someone's blood.
Oh my god, a belt with Rihanna blood on it. That's like getting a super fit board on QVC and then getting Lori Grainer's sweat thrown on it for free. That being said, do you think Chris will take 60?
Nah, I don't know about all that now. But you could negotiate with Chris himself. I mean, he's right inside, watching karate videos and recording 6 albums. I'm sure he'd love to haggle the price with you.
Well, I have a sinking suspicion that Chris Brown doesn't really like to negotiate with ladies. I mean, look how well it went for Rihanna, right? I think maybe you should do it, Jeff.
Sure, Chris Brown doesn't do anything crazy towards men.
Of course not.
Sure, go on, talk to him.
Okay, cool.
Oh my gosh, this is so exciting. It's like being in a 1990s tag sale at Mike Tyson's house.
Mr. Brown! Could I get this belt for $60?
Jeff, oh my god, are you okay?
Yeah, sure am. I talked him down to $62.25. I think I'm losing consciousness.
Will
that be cash or Bitcoin? Mr. Brown owns a lot of Bitcoin.
We're just gonna do cash.
Hi, excuse me.
Hi.
This shirt, is this the one
Chris Brown got arraigned in after his 2013 arrest for assaulting a parking attendant? The first time he assaulted a parking attendant? Yes, sir, it is! Wow. The genuine article.
I told my husband it looked like the shirt where the... But can you tell me where this blood spatter is? Where that would undoubtedly go with a designer shirt worn by Chris Brown?
Yes, yes, of course. Now see, Mr. Brown loved this shirt. He got it dry cleaned. Mm-hmm. But if you look at the collar, you'll see a speck of blood from the dry cleaner. Now see, he was talking about he got a charge extra because he's destroying police evidence and...
Hey, it's right there!
Oh my god!
Oh,
this is a piece of history, honey.
Yeah!
We gotta get this. How much does Chris ask you for?
Well, he was at a stiff $201.37, but I'm sure he's willing to take the best offer. Why don't you go on in and see?
Okay, I guess I'll make an offer.
Okay.
Welcome.
Is this the vest Chris Brown wore during his 2014 community service for assaulting two men for asking him for a photo?
Yes, 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 sir, it is. And if you're interested, I also have the 2016 community service vest. You know, the one where he stood off against LAPD and SWAT.
That's like a matching set. Oh my god, I would love that. It all depends on the price.
Yeah, well, you may have to haggle the price with Mr. Brown yourself. I mean, after he's done with the gentleman in there now. All right, sounds like he's finished with the previous buyer. Go on in.
Will do.
Oh, Mark, did Chris Brown lower the price?
Oh, Chris Brown tries to hurt Mark.
Wake up, Mark! What did Chris set the price for?
He did even 200. Somebody's bleeding inside me.
Oh, wow! Chris Brown is a tough negotiator, but 200 seems fair.
Cash or Bitcoin?
Well, hell, let's do cash.
Great.
Oh.
Apparently, Chris wants to keep the 2016 vest.
Hello.
I would love to get a price on that car Chris Brown used to run someone over with in 2013.
Which car?
There's more than one.
Oh, yes, lovely lady. Why don't you go on inside and see for yourself? Oh,
that sounds very reasonable.
Yes, yes, yes. This is going to be a long-ass sale.
Hey, Rick, what's up?
Oh, hey, Bob. Where are you?
Yeah, I'm in Boston.
I'm in Miami. Hang on, I got another call.
Yeah, I'll hold.
Hey, Sue, I'm in Miami.
Oh, you're in Miami? I'm in Bismarck.
Oh, honey, I just love driving out in these Kansas plains with you.
Yeah, it reminds me of the time we were driving in England.
Oh, I just love driving in England with you.
I can't believe I'm in jail for a crime I didn't commit! Don't worry, we're gonna solve this crime with the help of this disembodied head.
I'm disembodied, and I fight crime.
Wow! Surfing in Hawaii is fantastic! Whoa!
St. Louis is beautiful this time of year.
Susan Bismarck!
Bismarck?
We're in Fairbanks, Alaska.
Oh, yeah.
Well, that was fun. What do we do now?
Like any good movie, we walk into the sunset.
Mama, when are they gonna come fix the internet?
Maggie, I told you I called the cable company and they'd be here soon.
Well, how soon is that gonna be?
Well, they're gonna be here soon. Why don't you just use your phone until they get here?
Mom, you know I can't TikTok and tweet at the same time on my phone.
Well, they're gonna be here soon, and you can tic-tac-toe as soon as they're finished.
Whatever.
Oh, maybe it's the cable guy. Oh, Lou, Clara, what's up?
Is your internet working?
Well, it hasn't been working all day.
Damn it!
It's gonna be all right, Lou.
Well, you know the doctor said that I have the most success mid-afternoon, and now it's mid-afternoon, and it's like I'm paralyzed.
You know. What's going on, guys? What's wrong?
Oh, just, it's no big deal, really. we're trying to do artificial insemination, and, and so the doctor said that he should, because Lou's sperm is not cooperating.
I have low motility.
He has low motility. Mm-hmm. And the doctor said that he should come home at this time of day, masturbate into a cup, so...
I have day sperm.
Yeah, because he has day sperm.
So, anyway, you know, it's just, with the internet being down, it's a little difficult for me to find material to, beat the bishop.
Why don't you just use your phone?
Oh, no! I don't want Verizon seeing the porn I watch. They're a very judgmental phone carrier.
Hopefully that's the cable company!
Good, because I'm ready to go.
Does someone need help with their World Wide Web?
Oh, thank goodness you're here. We've been offline for like 3 Trump tweets.
No problem, ma'am. I will get you back up in no time.
That'd be great. Oh, speaking of being backed up, do you maybe have a plastic cup and a tablet? Because I'll just go post up in the bathroom and Claire, just let me know when the internet's back up and running, huh?
You want to show me where your modem is?
It's right over there. Maybe I should have turned it off for 10 seconds and turned it back on.
Yeah, speaking of getting turned on, the tablet.
In the desk. In the drawer.
Mazel.
Okay, yeah, I think I found the root to your problem.
Well, what is it?
Keanu Reeves, ma'am. He broke the internet.
What?
Keanu Reeves, ma'am. I guess there was a photo of him holding hands with Helen Mirren, and it just broke that internet all the way up.
Oh, that's totally plausible.
Oh, it's not just plausible, ma'am. It is very, 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 very plausible. All right? At any moment of any day, we are just one picture of Justin Bieber's bastard child away from having to go back to reading books to get information.
Is that true?
Oh, it's not just true, ma'am. The internet is but a fragile child, a butterfly flapping its wings into the unknown, if you will. When Al Gore invented the internet, he had no idea that one day Bella Thorne would one day be on it. In other words, it's like a house of cards. Or, Well, really, we're just to be really thankful that Miley Cyrus doesn't Instagram as much as she used to.
Great. So, you know, when's it going to be back up and running? My husband, he needs to masturbate before rush hour.
Has he tried, I don't know, mental images and essential oils? It works for me.
I will suggest that next time.
Hey, honey, I'm home.
Hey. Hi.
Clara, hey, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
Who's this guy?
This is the cable guy. Lou and I came over. Lou would like to use your internet to masturbate.
Does your internet frown upon that?
The internet is down and so's theirs.
Oh, well, yeah. Makes sense. I think the internet's out everywhere. That's why I'm home early from work. No internet, no reason to sit around and procrastinate.
Mm. Blame it on Keanu.
Keanu? That cat movie by Key and Peele? I mean, you know, Key really did a good thing getting rid of his dead weight.
Yes, yes, he was. But no, I'm not talking about that terrible film. I'm talking about Chain Reaction star Keanu Reeves.
Apparently he broke the internet by with the photo up of him holding a woman.
Mm.
That makes sense.
Well, looks like my job here is done.
So the internet's fixed?
Sir, no one person can fix what is called the internet. We just have to wait until this whole Keanu thing dies down. In about 2 to 3 business days, you're going to be getting a call from my boss. Could you give me like 5 stars? Thanks.
There goes my chance of getting pregnant. Lou! Get out here!
Sorry, I made do with the Lane Bryant catalog, but I dropped the cup.
Internet.
Oh, hey, Jack, I didn't know you were home.
Yeah, don't touch me with that hand.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ben Provist.
There's just no easy way to say it, and I know I've been a bad guy, but I've been thinking about the life that we used to have together. If I could find a way to play it, I would have done exactly that by now. 'Cause my body is aching, I'm tired of all this walking around. I miss you, but I miss your power. It's rough, but it's true. I miss going fast. Back to you in your sweet warm embrace. I get straight on and run and run. I could take that road forever. Oh yeah, on Sundays we could travel to the beach. We lay out in the sun. I pick you up from Elliot's, drive you around and get your errands done. I'm like a bird trapped in a cage.
lame tonight?
Tell me about it. Not one decent looking guy here to talk to.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we should probably bounce.
Good idea. Oh my god, is that Pete Davidson?
Oh my god, that's either Pete Davidson or someone dressed up as like a strung out heroin addict for Halloween.
Halloween was last week, Joe.
Oh my god, it was. Then yeah, it's definitely Pete Davidson.
Wow, I was never sure why so many pretty girls dated him, but now seeing him in public, I'm even more confused.
I think he's telling that guy to come over to us.
Why?
I don't know, but like, just act cool. We'll find out.
Cool.
Yeah, cool.
Hello, ladies.
Hi.
Hi. Hello.
You see my friend Pete over there?
Yep.
He sent me over here to see if you'd like to join our VIP table. You know, have a few drinks. On him, of course.
Well, that's very nice of him and Pete Davidson and you. And, but no, thank you.
Yeah.
No? Are you sure? Pete is one entertaining mother father.
So we're very sure. But be sure to thank that entertaining MF for us.
Okay. All right. You ladies have a good night.
Oh, thank you.
Cheers.
Okay.
Hey, man, you dropped your wallet?
No, Amber, I think you did that on purpose.
Why do you think he'd do that, Jill?
Well, because he took his wallet out of his pocket, looked straight at us, and then dropped it on the floor.
Yeah, that looks pretty on purpose to me, too.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I bet this is the kind of tactic that, like, Pete Davidson uses to lure women in.
Oh, the old drop your wallet so the pretty girls will bring it to your table trick?
It's the oldest trick in the book.
You think?
Mm-hmm.
This is the kind of crafty tactics that only a professional horn dog like Pete Davidson would employ.
Mm-hmm.
Well, should we just return the wallet then?
No, no. That's exactly what he wants. Just leave it there. Not our problem.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, it's a very nice wallet. But like...
Yeah, it's decent. Mm-hmm. Wait, I think he's sending over a different guy.
Oh.
Maybe he's coming over to get the wallet.
Maybe.
Mm-hmm. Oh, hi, ladies.
Hi.
My friend here, he's a little clumsy and dropped this wallet right here.
Yeah, well, it's a good thing you came to get it because we were not going to bring it over.
Mm-hmm.
And it would have been such a shame because it had such an amazing watch inside. It's a really nice watch, isn't it?
It's okay.
Okay, now take a closer look. Take a nice, long, hard look at this beautiful watch. Do you know who owns this watch?
No. Tell us.
The man who owns this watch is one of the most attractive, well-endowed men in the world. Pete Davidson.
Amber! Renee, snap out of it!
Oh,
oh my god!
What just happened?
He just tried the old hypnotize women to bring them over to the guy's table trick.
That's the second oldest trick in the book, next to dropping your wallet.
No, I was just trying to show you a nice watch that my friend almost lost.
Yeah, okay, nice try.
Oh, come
nice
on,
try.
We're fine.
Take the watch and walk.
Yeah, tell Pete Davidson he can't hypnotize women like us.
Yeah.
Don't you think that was a little bit harsh, Amber? Renee, you can never be too harsh on a guy who tries to hypnotize you to get with Pete Davidson.
Yep.
Come on.
Oh, come on. Again, now the gypsy woman's gonna come over here.
Oh, gypsy. Oh, no. We better be careful. Gypsies are known for stealing. What if she's coming over here to steal our hearts for Pete Davidson? What do you want, gypsy?
Ladies, I'm no expert, but I think she's trying to put some kind of gypsy spell on us. Okay. God,
a gypsy spell?
To make us get down with Pete Davidson.
To make us get down with Pete Davidson? That's the third oldest trick in the book!
Wow, Pete Davidson really has that book down pat.
Now, you listen up, you gypsy! I don't care what kind of gypsy spell you're gonna try to put on us, we are not getting with Pete Davidson.
Mm-hmm.
Ow! You gypsy bitch!
On, Renee,
make you want to get down to Pete Davidson.
Oh, that would be totally rude.
Mm-hmm.
You know what? I've had it with this Pete Davidson trying to fool us and hypnotize us and put a gypsy spell on us so that we'll get with him. I'm gonna go over there and give it a piece of my mind.
Wait, Renee, no, you'll never survive his magnetic allure.
Is she gonna be all right?
I don't know, Pete Davidson is really crafty.
You know what? Ariana sang about that in one of her songs.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wait.
Hi. Renee.
Hey.
Are you okay?
Oh, me?
Yeah.
Yeah, that Pete Davidson really is so charming.
Seriously?
Yeah, and he's really sorry that he tried to fool us and hypnotize us and put a gypsy spell on us, just so that we'd get with him.
He is?
Yeah, he's really sorry. See?
Aww. Well, he does look really sorry.
Yeah, he actually really does.
Well, let's just go over there and tell him it's okay.
Sure, yeah.
Okay.
Not a big deal.
We're good. Yeah.
Whistleblower, on behalf of all of us, thank you so much for what you've done for this country.
Yeah, whistleblower. Seriously. You and Lizzo are my heroes.
Aww. Oh, you guys, it's just...
Oh!
What?
What?
I know, I'm sorry I fooled you all into thinking that I was a Ukrainian whistleblower, but it's just me. Matthew Marcy, Instagram hold Matthew.Marcy, Twitter Matthew_Marcy, Facebook /Matthew Marcy.
Okay, wow, yeah, wow, Matt, really is you, and I feel duped.
Yeah, Matt, like, why would you even do that?
Yeah.
Extra stage time.
Okay, that's a good idea.
Well, now that we're all past this, any last stories you got?
Oh, yeah, fans of Dancing with the Stars are really furious every week because former Trump Press Secretary Sean Spicer keeps getting the lowest scores from the judges, but survives because Trump followers keep voting for him.
He's never going to win, though.
Why not?
No Electoral College.
Oh, waka waka.
You're bad. I'm so mad.
Stop.
And the new Martin Scorsese film, The Irishman, opened this past week to nearly universal praise.
Oh, yeah. This is the most liked Irishman since Bono.
Like, cause Bono's Irish and like, people like.
Are you saying bongo?
No, I'm sorry.
No. This punk thinks he's gonna move on us. Us? Yeah. He's got another thing coming.
Yeah, he's got another thing coming. What you thinking, boss?
You know what I'm thinking?
Yeah.
I think if we get to him first, we whack him out.
Oh, boss. He's a made guy. We whack him out without the permission of the council. We got the other families coming against us.
Nah, you're right, Sally. We gotta do it, whack him out, and make it look like it wasn't us.
Maybe we get somebody from outside of the family to whack him out.
Yeah, like an outside contractor. Yeah. Anybody know somebody?
I might have a guy.
Vito, you know a guy?
I might. Like I said, I might.
Okay, so who's your guy?
The Irishman.
Is that Johnny O'Toole from Ganassi?
No, not him.
Mickey O'Toole from Bay Ridge.
Not him either.
Yeah, Peter O'Toole from that Lawrence of Arabia.
Nah, it's another guy. Here, let me text him. He usually responds really fast.
Did somebody call for me?
Wow, there he is, boys, fellas, it's Lucky C.
Top of the morning to you.
What's up, C?
I'm sorry, is nobody else noticing that this guy is dressed like one of them Irish midgets?
It's leprechauns, not midgets, you freaking prick. You try that again, you'll feel my shillelagh in your arse.
Oh, is that right? Excuse me, Seamus. Is anybody else noticing the leprechaun gear?
Tony, I think it's, he's Irish. I think it's his culture and shit. You know,
Yeah, it's like them Polacks wearing them runnings.
Yeah.
Oh, I think it's divorce.
Yeah, not for nothing, but I know a couple of mixes, and none of them dressed like this.
Oh.
Vito, you really vouch for this guy? Yeah, I vouch for him. All right, if you vouch for him.
I do.
Just say it.
I got plenty of other shite I can be dealing with. You fellas want to get to the point of my visit.
Yeah, we need you to whack somebody out.
Oh, whack a guy out, you say?
Yeah. Yeah. He's been making moves on us. We gotta take him.
You know, Tony, let me handle this. Yeah. All right, so the guy we need you to whack out is, it's a guy, we think he wants to steal your Lucky Charms.
Messing with me Lucky Charms? Oh, you point me in the direction of that right bastard. I'll set him straight.
You know, all right,
yeah. Right, yeah, we get the address right here, and write it down, there we go.
All right. take care of this guy.
No problem. Anyone who messes with me Lucky Charms, they deserve the fate they receive.
This guy better know what he's doing.
Hey, he sounded pretty serious to me, you know?
Mr. Tony, I need your help.
Angelina, what's wrong? Baby? Oh,
it's the landlord at my parents' store. He's trying to kick them out so he can charge higher rent to some Pollock who wants to open up a running suit store for Pollocks.
Goddamn Pollocks!
Listen, baby, don't you worry about it. Uncle Tony's gonna take care of you, okay?
Grassy.
Okay.
That's a whole lot of grats, you know what I'm saying?
Hey, Sue was real grateful for you, Bus.
Yeah, well, they give us something to be grateful for, huh?
Like what? What are you gonna do?
Well, the reasonable thing we can do. We've gotta whack out the landlord.
Oh, yeah. That seems like the most sensible solution.
Yeah. I gotta ask my boy C, you know, if he does a good job with his first job.
Yeah. That makes sense. Well, I think you fellas may have been a bit mistaken there with the information he gave me. I found the bastard that you directed me to, but when I spoke to him, he didn't know what the fuck I was talking about.
What'd you do?
Oh, well, first I poured kerosene on him, and then I fed him to a wood chipper, and then I lit his remains of fire, but still, he gave me nothing but me Lucky Charms.
That's a good job, Steve. That's a good job. Good job. Yeah, speaking of jobs, you know, we got another one for you. We got this guy, he's forcing out some of
them. You know, we got this, there's another guy we need you to take care of. He's, we think he's the one who actually took your Lucky Charms.
My Lucky Charms, you're sure this time?
I'm sure.
He likes to lie, so if he says he doesn't have your Lucky Charms, straighten out for lying too, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, I'm way ahead of you, brother.
Right. You know, here's the address, why don't you go get your Lucky Charms?
Will do.
Mildly inappropriate.
Yeah, a little bit.
Oh, the Kiss Me, I'm Irish thing. I think that's what it is.
Whatever. Oh, hey. Ma, Pop, what are you doing here?
Tony, we need your help over here.
What?
Yeah, the street punk keeps harassing your mother.
What? Well, you give me a name. You got a name?
He's real easy to spot. He's always hanging about the coffee shop.
He's always wearing one of them running suits.
Pollocks!
Maybe I never saw him and another guy trying to screw in a light bulb, so I'm not sure.
Don't you worry, Mama. I'm gonna take care of these guys for you, okay?
You better. I'll cut you out of the wheel.
Oh, come on, Pop. I got you. Come on.
You're a good boy.
Thank you, Mama.
You're a good boy.
Thank you, Mama.
You're a good boy.
Boss, what are you gonna do? You gonna reason with the Pollock? You can't reason.
Yeah, there's only one reasonable thing we can do.
Whack him out.
Yeah, exactly. Whack him out. That's right. Yeah. All right. The guy can handle this, we think. Yeah.
It's possible.
Oh, well, faith in Megora, fellas. I found that fella you pointed me to, and I gotta tell you, I pulled out each and every one of his fingernails. I then hit him myself, two toenails. And when that didn't work, I shoved him into the boot of a car, and then I shoved the car into one of them car crushing machines. But still, nothing about me Lucky Charms.
That's too bad, you know what? That's too bad. But hey, we got another one for you. Yeah? Mike, if you don't want, you just tell him about it.
All right, I'll tell him. So this time, we need you to take out is he's a Pollock.
A Pollock, you say?
Yeah, a Pollock with your Lucky Charms. Yeah.
A Pollock's messing with me Lucky Charms! Oh!
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, Ben Provost.
What about the rock? I'm writing this song for you tonight. You're so close, but we'll be the stars don't shine. I know it doesn't make a difference to you, but I'll keep writing songs till the stars go blue.
still use my feet to get around. I wish I owned my own cinema. Beverly Boulevard, where I could shoot the films in my own yard. Sort of like Marvel, the never-ending sequel, or a film where you're only a shock of people.
Of American Idol, where Simon Cowell didn't wear nipple shirts.
We have to come up with a plan.
Well, I've got the plan.
You've got a plan? He's got a plan.
Okay. Got the plan. It's a little unorthodox, a little out of the box, but it might work.
Yes. For Christ's sake, tell us.
It's funny you say that. Who is the demographic that Sean Spicer is drawing from? Who could we get that would take from that demographic?
The guys with torches from Charlottesville.
Yes, but not them.
What?
Sheriff Joe Arpaio or Judge Jeanine Pirro.
No, not them either.
Well, then who?
Jesus.
Jesus? Like the Lord and Savior? Like Jesus?
Yeah, one and the same.
You got Jesus.
I got the Jesus.
Wow, that is a great get.
Okay.
How'd you do that?
Apparently him and, Carrie Ann Arbor have the same agent.
Oh, really? Oh, wow, really?
There's only one catch, though.
Oh, what?
Okay. Apparently, Jesus, he has two left feet.
Two left
what?
Oh. Two left feet?
Oh, is that because of, like, you know, the cross?
I think he told me it's because they did not dance back then. Maybe it's something to do with the sandals.
Okay, so what are we going to do to fix this?
Well, I'll tell you what. I've hired Anna Trebiowski to train him.
Whoa. Yes. Did you say Anna Trubinskaya?
Yes, Anna Trubinskaya is training Jesus.
Oh my goodness, why, if she can make Gary Busey dance, she should have it easy going with the Son of Man. A lot of miracles.
Simple. They are on their way as we speak.
Amazing. Oh my God. Wait, they're here?
They're coming. Oh, they're here! Anna Jesus. Hey, Joanne, too. Thank you. Producers of Dancing with the Stars.
Oh, hello. Yes.
Hey.
Welcome.
Not to be a doubting Thomas, but how do we know
know you're the real Jesus and not the homeless guy who defecates by the stage door.
Mm-hmm. Now it's me, born of a virgin, JC.
I'm just, you say that, but how do we know?
Mm-hmm. Pick a number between 1 through 15 and I'll guess it.
Okay.
9.
What? You are Jesus.
Yeah.
It was 8, but he was
close. Like I said. Like I said.
Okay.
Hey, Anna. So, how is Jesus coming along?
Oh, God, no. Not good. He is more like Master P than Drew Lachey.
Master P?
Hey, my children, I am doing the best I can, okay? This is dancing we're talking about, not turning water into wine. Are you good on wine?
Oh, I would love
what? Mr. Jesus Christ, let's actually see some of this dancing.
All right, fine, but pardon the pun, just don't crucify me if it's not good, okay?
Oh,
I'll
be so funny.
That was a good one.
So funny. I like that.
I'm going to write that down.
You write it down, write it in the book. All right,
well, that's it. All
right.
So, we dance to Britney Spears, Toxic.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm a huge fan of Britney. Well, now. There were a couple of years, though.
All right, cue the music.
The thing is, if we put you on the stage like that, it will be the second time you will have died for our sins.
Wow. Exactly. I couldn't have said it better.
Jesus Christ. Okay, well, hey, you know what, guys? I gave it a shot. I think I'm just gonna...
No,
Jesus,
come on.
You are the only prayer we have to take votes away from... Sean Spicer, what are you doing here?
Gross.
You know, I heard you Hollywood liberals are going to try something like putting grease on my shoes, or shining the spotlight in my eyes while I was trying to dance, or switching our audience with the one going to Ellen. But I never thought you would stoop so low as to bring in the Son of God to compete against me. Jesus, how could you after all I talked to you about?
Oh, come on, man. I'm just trying to get back into the public eye. I've had a few lean years. And besides, could you stop talking to me about you playing with yourself? All right, just because I'm all seeing doesn't mean I got to be all hearing about it, too.
Jesus, I have mad respect for you. But if you think you're going to outdance me, you're more wrong than you were about Judas.
Oh, no, he didn't. Oh, no, he did not just bring up the chance.
Wow.
He did not just bring him Judas.
Wow.
He did. No, he did not.
I think I heard it.
Did he just bring that up?
Yeah, I heard it.
Yes. I heard it.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I'm sorry. Did I say Judas?
Oh, I don't know.
I meant to say Judas. Judas.
It is so on.
Wait, maybe this is the key to unlocking Jesus' groovy side. Yes. Righteous fury.
Yes.
Yes, go. Yes.
Oh.
Yes. Jesus.
Oh.
Yes, Jesus. Yes.
Yes. Where's my dancer?
What? I don't want.
You are so going down, pal.
It's gonna take a miracle for you to keep up with me.
Yeah, well, I deal in miracles, dumbass.
You're just doing hand stuff. What is you're supposed to be dancing, Sean. Well, I'm sorry we don't have a trippy background of you dancing around.
Get up.
Okay.
Yeah, go back.
Ow.
Jesus!
Jesus!
I got an idea!
Oh, what's your idea? Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
If we join forces, nobody can stop us.
Oh, we will smite the competition!
No, Jesus!
No! Then it's settled. We're each other's new partners.
No, stop
talking to us!
No,
I should have seen this coming!
No!
There goes our season!
Well, I guess there's nothing left to do but dance, huh?
Yes!
Dance?
Dance?
we'll be there with a crazy glue. For TMI Hollywood, I'm Michael Monroe. Goodman. Thank y'all. Good night.